Hello everyone. So today I welcome to Invincible our debut author, Mr. Parmeet Singh. Hi Parmeet sir, how
Hello,
are you?
I'm fine, how are you?
Firstly, let me congratulate you for a beautiful novel, The Chase of Dreams.
Thank you so much.
So I tell my people that this book is launched in 16 November, and you must read it. So today we are going to have a chit chat with you regarding the book, and I'm looking forward to that. So the chase of dream, when I read these three words, so is it the dreams that we see, we chase them, or what? I want to know it from your end.
No, here the I want to tell you, tell everyone that the title is a bit tricky. It is not that that someone is chasing his or her dreams, but it is like the dreams has chased someone's life.
The dream has chased someone's life. Just okay. That. So in this book, the characters that you have written, like I have gone through the characters, and they are very unique name, very English name, like Emma, Patrick, Angel. So how come these name in your mind?
The first thing is that, you know, everything is getting westernized.
That's true.
Okay, so I thought that yes, these names and these characters would be a bit of, you know, interesting, and someone who will read it can connect to the story, because the storyline, the demand of storyline was that these names should be like this, okay, and the characters should be like this.
Okay, so you, I want you to tell my people, my audience, more about the story. What is the story about? How it start and everything.
Okay, so basically what it is that it is a story of a girl.
Okay.
Okay. Since her birth till her ending, the day she is done, she is being chased by the dreams. Okay. Everything good or bad happened in her dreams, she already knew about that.
Okay.
Rather, her mother knew about that.
Wow.
But they were not able to change anything. So that's why we say that yes, the dreams changed her whole life.
Okay.
And it impacted a lot.
Okay.
And the one thing that is a special, and I really wanted to mention it, that people expect a very happy ending in each and everything, but in a real life it doesn't happen.
Right.
So it is not a happy ending, it is a very interesting ending.
It's a very interesting ending, I must say. I've gone through the book and it there. So I want to know more about how you get this, you know, idea of this book, and is there any specific reason that you have written this book?
No, actually, the first thing is that yes, every story and everyone goes around with the dreams only.
Right.
So the first thing, dreams. Second thing that, yeah, I'm from a medical background, and
okay,
I studied a lot and many things. So I was going through some psychiatric symptoms as well. So in that, there is such situation where the dreams are, you know, the people get the dreams and those are in reality. The reality happens. So from there I got the idea and I just moved on with the storyline.
That's great. So how much time did you take to complete this book?
If you see the size of the book, it, you will not believe me, but yes, it took at least 1.5 years for me.
1.5 years?
Yes, yes. Actually, the thing was that earlier the story was very lengthy.
Okay.
And I myself found that it was not connected.
Okay.
So I reduced the words and made it in this way.
So who is your major character here in the storyline?
The major character, two major characters are there. One is Emma. Other one is Angel.
So they, are they mother daughter?
Yeah.
Okay.
Emma is Angel's mother.
Okay.
So she is the main character, because she was the one who made Angel realize that she is having some powers of dreams.
Okay.
And Angel is the major one because everything happened with her only.
Okay. So for Angel, this chase of dreams, the dreams that she used to saw, were a blessing or a boon? What do you think it was for her?
Actually, I would say that it was a blessing or a boon. It was much of a reality. So one thing, it comes along with a message as well, that reality never changes. And she knew her reality, that what in future is going to happen with her. But still she was not able to change that. She tried a lot, her mother tried a lot, but they were not able to change anything. It exactly happened as she saw in her dreams.
So those dreams that really affect her life and her mother life, everyone who was associated with them?
It affected everyone's life.
Okay. everyone.
Because the thing is that it is not somehow something like a power. She knew just the reality that what exactly going to happen with the other persons. So yes, she knew everything.
So as you said, ki, she was never able to stop her or change anything. Did she try her best?
She tried her level best. But they were never able to change anything. The things they happened exactly the same. There are many incidences like, I'd like to share how her mother died, how her husband died, and how she went into the coma. It's more of a sad story, but in the end, you'll get some motivation as well.
Okay, so as I have read the story, it does have a lot of plots, lot of suspense is there. Every chapter there is a new suspense that attracts reader to go to the next page and know, okay, what is next. So if you want to give me a one-liner for this book, for your audience, so what would be the one-liner for this book?
The one-liner for this book is going to be that the chase of dreams is not just a book, it's a feeling. And you'll come to know about that feel when you purchase it and you read it.
So when you personally had those feelings, I want to become a writer and I want to start my work and this would be my first book. So when this feeling come in your mind and in your heart?
That's also one different story. Actually, I was staying in a PG for approximately 3 to 4 months, and one of my roommate was already a writer.
Okay.
And he has written a book, and I was very impressed from him. It was a Saturday night. We both were there, and the third roommate wasn't there. We were just talking about each other's life because that was the first time we came to know about each other. That yeah, he was working in TCS, and everyone was busy with their work. So at that time he motivated me that you should write if you are having some ideas. So it was a motivation from a stranger.
Oh, nice. So a stranger is the main person.
Main person, yeah.
Okay, great. So when I personally read this book, I felt there was a link between every character somehow.
Yeah.
Right? So every character is correlated, or you linked it. What is the main flow on that?
The thing is that, again I'll say that I have tried to depict the reality in this. Okay. So in reality, that how incidences happens, because it is not going to happen that an incidence was there and nobody was there.
Right.
In that. So I tried to have some characters, indulge some characters who are having just one or two pages appearance in this book.
Okay.
But they are there.
Yeah.
So to make the connectivity of the book and to make the storyline, I had to go with this.
Okay. So this book is a fiction one. So any particular reason why into fiction?
I love fiction.
You love fiction.
Because the thing is that I never had, read fiction, or I never watched fiction. That was my brother who took me to a theater once, and we were having this movie of Marvel.
Okay.
And at that time, I didn't even knew about the characters. But when I saw, it was a very happy thing because there was something apart from the reality. And it is a human nature that yes, whenever you are free or you are a bit stressed, you want to live in your dreams and you want to live in your world only. So that is your world. The fiction is your world. This is not your world.
So you dreamt about this book, about publishing this book, and finally this book is in your hand. How do you feel?
It is a very awesome feeling, and I love this thing. And till the end, when the book was about to launch, I was not at all sure that book has been printed yet. I was looking for it at the site, but yeah, okay. So yeah, it was a very good feel, and I'm really proud of it that yes, I have done something good in my life.
That's great.
That I'm very proud of myself.
So as a debut author, how was your journey with Invincible Publisher?
It was also a different story. The first one was Tamanna Ma'am Only You,
yes,
that I connected with, and Ajay sir being my senior in my school, he was my school senior also. So yeah, it's like a family feeling, not that I'm here as a customer or like that. It's just like I'm coming to my home only. I'm there with my friends.
We are always happy to welcome you. So, last thing that you want to tell our audience about this book, to tell your readers about this book. to give a message?
So the message is that yes, everyone is having a writer in him. You know, it takes just a courage to pen it down. So anyone can be a writer, anyone can publish the book. So just have a courage for that and be motivated. Yeah, I'm not a regular reader. I'm not a one who is very, you know, good with the books. I never used to study as well. I was a very bad student, but still this book is in my hand with my name. So yes, if I can do, anyone can do it.
And to your readers who are going to read this book, this beautiful book, what do you want to say?
Jaldi khareedo, jaldi padh lo, out of stock nahi honi chahiye. So this is a very good book. I'll say that yes, I am proud of my work because I have done something different. With the, you know, nowadays people used to have the love stories and everything like that. So this is a fiction which is a bit different from other things. So you really like it, do purchase and go for the Invincible.
I'm sure. Thank you everyone. Thank you for me, sir, and again a big congratulations for this book.
Thank you so much. Thank you everyone.